Good morning friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn the bar bending schedule of raft foundation. Last video I have explained you what is a foundation, what are its uses, its properties, its advantages, disadvantages and many more. So if you want to skip the theory part, you can directly skip to the video like of AutoCAD drawing explanation and the Excel sheet of bar bending schedule and the manual calculations. Okay, so I'm going to give you a little bit hint about what is a raft foundation, what are its important considerations and blah blah blah. So let's go for it. While explaining, I'll show you some photographs so that you don't get bored. Okay, so let's start with it. According to Google, a raft foundation is a reinforced concrete slab under the hull of a building or extension, floating on the ground as the raft floats on water. This type of foundation spreads the load of the building over a large area than other foundations, lowering the pressure on the ground. This is the definition of raft foundation. Let's start with it. The raft is an alternative if you can use a traditional strip or trench fill foundation. But it's important to note that the raft foundation aren't suitable in all cases and usually need to be designed by a structural engineer. Now we are going to see some important considerations about raft foundation. A raft design usually has an edge beam formed by a cage of steel reinforcement, which will need to be carefully assembled on site. Internal stiffness beams are used. Sometimes these beams transfer the load of the building through the rest of the slab and even over the ground. The site investigations is usually needed for the engineer to understand what the ground is like. Very poor ground may mean you need a different solution, such as piles. Okay, the raft design will normally need a hardcore sub base to level the ground. This stone should be mechanically impacted. You must ensure steel reinforcement in lapping of at least 450 mm for both mesh and mild steel bars, and providing with 40 mm cover. Concrete cover or clear cover, you can pronounce like that. Drilling in the reinforcement during the concrete pour isn't a suitable means of placing reinforcement. Use the special chairs to support the mesh. The edge of the raft must be carefully detailed for the dam course and membrane position, which may need a step forming in the concrete at raft edge. The insulation is usually placed over the raft top. Take care to avoid cold bridging at the junction with external walls. Okay, here you can see the schematic representation of beam and raft slab action. Okay, the resistance between the column and the earth fill. I want to just add a point that a structural engineer designing a raft foundation may not be fully aware of the dam coursing, cold bridging or land contamination issues. Ensure that the building designer consideration the detail before constructing the raft. Once the concrete is poured in it, it may be difficult to overcome. If in doubt, speak to your local authority building control surveyor. Let's move forward. Okay, so here we have AutoCAD drawing of a raft foundation. This is very hosh-posh thing. We have seen this drawing in pile foundation also, but the drawing was different. The plot was same. Okay, this drawing is of raft, the drawing was of piles. Okay, so here the BS1 and BS2 are the two rafts. First, let me explain you what are these two. You may look over here. These are the piles driven. The two types of piles explained in previous lecture, the load bearing piles and the compound piles. Okay, so the excavation is done in two parts. Firstly, the excavation was done up to the PCC level under BS1, and secondly, the excavation was done 1500 mm for BS2. They have just saved the money. They have not excavated enough for BS2. Sorry. So after they excavated, the PCC was laid. The bituminous layer of polythene was laid, and then they have done binding of steel reinforcement, and then concreting was done. Okay, so we'll learn this in this section. In this section, it is shown how the steels are binded up, and we will take out the quantity of steel they have used over here. Okay, so these are two types of rafts, BS1 and BS2. The BS1 is the inner part and BS2 is the outer part. You might say that there is very hosh-posh, many things are displayed in a graph. So let me show you a clear diagram. Okay, so I just noted down over here. You can see the plot. Here you can see the internal part is BS1. The dimension of BS1 is 41.906 meter by 20.04 meter. Okay, the next is BS2, means the upper part is BS2. So we will calculate BS2 in three ways. First, we will just join the line from here, then we'll calculate this rectangle of BS2, then this rectangle of BS2, and the diagonal part of BS2. Okay, now in the explanation, I will explain only BS1 and explain you how the diagonal part of BS2 will be calculated. Okay, so this is the section. These are some basic information given in the drawing. Let me show you where it's given. It's always given in the schedule. First of all, the schedule of BS1 and BS2. The BS1 depth is 1.35 meter and BS2 depth is 0.6 meter. BS1 top jali, top main bar, your top mesh is 25 dia at the rate 100 mm center to center, and BS2 is 16 dia at the rate 150 mm center to center. That of bottom jali or bottom mesh is of 25 dia at the rate 100 mm center to center and 16 dia at the rate 150 mm center to center respectively. And these are the remarks given. There is a base raft. Okay, so these are the RCC walls. We'll learn in further classes. This is the schedule of columns they have provided over there. So in this, we have no use of this. The steel given, the concrete mix given, and the soil bearing capacity is given. It's 250 kilonewton per meter square. It's more than enough for the raft foundation. Okay. These are the cover given we have to take for raft 50 mm. You have to just read all the specifications, the general notes and everything to get a bit assured what you are doing. Okay, so let's start with it. We first of all, we'll draw the diagram of this over here. It's done. This is the retaining wall. The top part is BS1, the bottom part is BS2. After the BS2 will be casted, we will fill it with the excavated soil, or we can also buy soil from another from shop, and then we'll do a tremix layer. This is the site example. Okay, now we'll see the boundary of the raft. The compound piles are here and the load bearing piles are under BS1. So here the raft size is given as length is equal to 41.906, width is equal to 20.04, and depth is equal to 1.35. In AutoCAD, we have calculated length and breadth, and the depth is given over here, 1.35 BS1 thickness. Okay, so let's move forward. The bottom long bar, we have discussed it now in the schedule of BS1. All these properties were given over there. The chairs were given. Actually, the chairs were not given accurate results. So at site, we took a chair of these two dimensions, and we have found out the cutting length, that is around 4 meter. And laps, I had explained you. Let me explain you again. What is a lap? Lap is the overlap part for the continuation of a reinforcement. What is the formula for lap? It is 50D, 50 times diameter of bar. If it is 25, then 50 times 25 divided by 1000 to get in meter. That is around 1.25 meter. Okay, So here it is written 2 laps in 1 bar. The length of 1 bar is 12 meter and the length of raft is 41. So to complete that span, we have to divide 41 by 12, and how many the number, it will be the number of laps. Okay, so here are some important formulas you have to keep in mind. The game of the formula is only this. Onto this formula, you can find quantities of the whole raft. Everything, PS1, PS2, everything. Okay, so let's concentrate on these formulas first. The first one is, or the main, what we are calculating. We are calculating the quantity of steel used in raft. So what is the formula for calculating quantity of steel? We are taking a bottom jali. The number of bars, number of reinforcement bars into length of one reinforcement bar into weight of 1 meter of steel bar. Then we will get the steel quantity for a raft. And then after getting the steel quantity of one raft, we will multiply by the number of raft to get the all steel quantities. Okay, now number of bars. There are three criteria: number of bars, length of one bar, and weight per meter. So there will be three different formulas. Okay, for weight per meter is d square l divided by 162, where d is the diameter of bar, diameter of one reinforcement bar. Okay, so this formula has arrived from mass is equal to density into volume. The formula, density is 7850 for steel and volume is pi by 4 d square into l, 1 meter. Okay, by calculating you will get d square l upon 162. Number of bar. The formula for number of bar is length of footing. If you want to calculate the numbers in that footing, if you want to calculate the numbers of short span, like if you want to calculate how many vertical bars are here, then you have to take the length of to get the number of bars, you have to take 20.04. if you want to calculate the bar length, if suppose your one bar length is 41.906 meters and you have to calculate how many 41.906 meters bars are there, you have to take a distance of 20.04. If the bar length of 20.04 meter is there, then you have to calculate how many bars of 20.04 meter is there, then you have to take the length as 41.906. Okay, so minus 2 times cover. Of course, you have to deduct the cover from both sides. We have just seen the AutoCAD drawing. There the cover has written as 50 mm, 0.1 meter. Okay, so spacing of steel bar. If you want to calculate the number, how you will calculate the number? If you want to calculate the horizontal bars numbers, then you will say that I will take this length 41.906 minus spacing minus cover divided by the spacing between the adjacent bars. Okay, now plus 1 for approx result. In previous lecture, I told you that the bar bending schedule is prepared 2 times. Firstly, before construction, that is according to drawing. The second one is after construction, that is taking the cutting length of reinforcement and then finding it out. Taking the correct number or noting down the correct number of reinforcement and then finding it out. We are calculating the approximately, so we'll have to take plus 1 over there. Okay, so length of one bar formula for length of one bar is the length of footing, of course, minus 2 times cover, of course, plus 2 times length of 90 degree bend. Now you might be thinking, what is a 90 degree bend? Let me show you over here. Can you see this bend? The reinforcement is coming from here and it's taking a 90 degree bend. This is the development length. Okay, so we have to add this development length also in a one in the reinforcement of one bar, right? So the formula for length of 90 degree bend, if it is not given in drawing, is depth of footing minus 2 times clear cover. If it is given in drawing like this, it's given 600 mm, then we have to take directly. Okay, So just let us put the formula in this thing. Like we'll take bottom jali, we'll have to put the same formula. We'll take top jali, we'll have to put the same formula. Okay, so let's move forward. So we have calculated the steel quantity for bottom jali on longer side. Okay, so number of long span bars. I have told you, if you have to calculate the long span bar, you have to take a short length minus 2 times cover divided by spacing of steel bar in how many adjacent bars are placed in how many adjacent spacing. Okay, plus 1 for approximately results. So you'll get approximately 201 numbers. Okay, the length of 90 degree bend, depth minus 2 times cover, depth is 1.35 meter minus 2 times 50 mm is 0.05, matlab minus means minus 0.1, so 1.25 meter. Okay, the length of one bar in long side, the length of long side footing is minus 2 times cover plus 2d. Here d is the length of 90 degree bend. Okay, so length of long side, for length of one bar we have to take length of long side, for number of long span we have to take short length. Simple funda. Okay, so let's start. Here the length of long side is 41.906 minus 2 times cover on both the sides plus 2 times d development length. Okay, though, so the length of one bar is 44.306 meter. Then weight for 1 meter of steel bar in long side, weight for 1 meter. Okay, so d square l upon 162, where d is in mm. So it is around 3850. So we'll divide it by 1000 to get 3.85 kg per meter. Here d is in mm, we have written it in meter, so please convert it. Quantity of steel in long side bottom jali. Now we have took out some quantities over here, and now we are multiplying all the quantities like number into length of one bar into weight per meter. We have got around 34.456 ton. Okay, just divide kg divided by 1000 is equal to ton. Now we are calculating the steel quantity for bottom jali short side. Same, we have calculated long side bottom jali, short side bottom jali. We have took length of long side, there we have took length of short side. Minus 2 times cover divided by spacing plus 1. 90 degree bend, depth minus 2 times cover. Length of one bar short of short side is length of short side. Minus 2 times cover plus 2 times the 90 degree bend. Okay, then weight of 1 meter length, the weight per meter is d square l upon 162, where d is the diameter, and we'll get in divided by 1000, so we'll get 3.85 kg per meter. Quantity of total quantity of steel in short side bottom jali is what we have calculated, number into length into weight, we have get around 36.288 tons. Okay, now steel quantity for top jali, same, repeat, copy paste. Number of long span bar, short length of footing minus 2 times cover divided by spacing plus 1. Length of 90 degree bend, here 0.6 meter is given. You can see over here the 90 degree bend, 600 mm is given. Okay, so length of long side one bar, so it is length of long side footing plus 2 times 90 degree bend minus cover. Okay, then weight of 1 meter, length of steel, d square l upon 162, 3.85 kg per meter. Quantity of steel in long side top jali, same, multiply all the values, you'll get 33.45710. Now you'll repeat in the steel quantity of top jali short side. First we have calculated steel quantity bottom jali long side short side. Now steel quantity top jali long side short side, same, repeated. Numbers at 420 numbers. 90 degree bend is 0.6 meter given. Then length of short side one bar is 21.24. Weight per meter, again for 25 mm bar, 3.85 kg per meter. And quantity of steel in short side top jali is 34.277 ton by multiplying all. Now here is a change. Now we are calculating the side tie along long side. What is the side tie? So you may you might see the reinforcement on the side part to tie the 90 degree bend from all sides. Okay, we provide side tie. Side tie along long side. Okay, so number of side ties, we have two sides, left, right. Okay, along long side, Let me show you. Side ties are placed on all the four sides of BS1. So there are two longer sides and two shorter sides. So we'll calculate accordingly. So for the formula for two longer sides, we have taken the number of side tie is two times longer sides into two for bars on each side. There are two bars on each side. Okay, so 2 times 2 is equal to 4 numbers of side ties are there on long side. Okay, then length of one bar is length of long side minus 2 times cover. Here we don't have a 90 degree length bend. Okay, then weight per meter, the same formula, d square l upon 162. Here d is of 10 mm. So we are the value has changed to 0.62 kg per meter. Then quantity of side tie along long side, same repeat formula, number into length into weight, 0.103 ton. Then short tie along side tie along short side, same. We have two sides, we have two number of bars, four numbers, length by same formula, weight per meter by same formula, quantity by same formula. Okay, now we are providing chairs. What is chair? Do you know what is a chair? You can see over here. This is a chair. This is a chair. These are chairs. What is the purpose of chair? What is the use of chairs? Chairs are provided because when we pour concrete, the weight of concrete is in M cube. It's very heavy. So it might bend the top jali. It might bend the top jali to resist that load. And to maintain a particular distance between bottom jali and top jali, we provide chairs. Okay, so we'll calculate the length of chair. First, the die of chair we took at site was 25 pi and 16 pi. The number of chairs for 25 pi as counted on site is 200 and for 16 is 152. The length of chair on site is 4 and 4 meter. The weight per meter is calculated with the formula d square l upon 162, and the quantity is calculated by number into length into weight per meter, and the total quantity is addition of them two. Okay, now we are providing the laps. There are two laps provided per bar length. We have calculated by the formula length of footing divided by 12, because 12 is the standard size according to IS codes. Okay, therefore the quantity of bottom long side bars is equal to the quantity of top long side bars. So we'll directly take it to that way and we'll multiply by 2 at the end. Okay, so this is the formula. Die is given, number of bars by same formulas, number of laps. Number of laps are there. There are 2 laps, the number of bars into 2, 402, total number of quantity, and the number is taken as 402. Okay, then the length of each lap is 50 times die. I repeated it previously also. So 1.25 meter weight per meter, and quantity is multiply the number with length with weight per meter. Same it with bottom short side bars and top short side bars also. Okay, the die, length, weight per meter, quantity, total quantity of laps. Now we are going to sum up with the total weight or quantity of raft BS1 except lift bed. You might be thinking, what is lift bed? So we have deducted this lift bed. We have deducted this lift bed. We have deducted this lift bed. We have three lifts in this area. So we have just cancelled that. So the total quantity of steel in raft BS1 except lift bed, we have calculated all the bottom long bars, short long bars, top long bars, top short bars, side tie along long side tie along short side, chair provided, and two different dias, 25 and 16 mm. Then laps provided, and we get the total quantity of 156.05 ton. Now these are the basic calculations that we do manually. Now we are going to study how we will convert these basic calculations into Excel sheet. So let's do it. this is the standard format of an Excel sheet. We have explained it on our previous lecture also. Okay, we have the description where we have using bottom long bar or short long bar or top long bar or top short bar. We have discussed over there the diameter of one bar, the shape of that bar. I have not included the shape of reinforcement in my previous lecture. I have upgraded this. The number of bars, length of one bar, we have calculated total length of all bars, means the number of bars into length of one bar. Weight per meter, the formula D square L upon 162, mass is equal to volume into density. Weight, total weight, that is total length multiplied by weight per meter, will get total weight. Then number of raft, we have 3 BH2 and 1 BS1, so 1 BS1, and total weight of steel quantity, then will distribute accordingly to the diameter of bars. Okay, so let's start with it. I just made a clear plan that I'll not waste my time writing this description because they do not contain any formulas or anything. They are just noted, written over here. Okay, so first of all, we'll start with the number of bars. We have calculated what are the number of bars. Let me show you again with this. This is the manual bar bending schedule. Okay, so we have took a 25 mm dia. We have taken the shape of the bar. Here it is number of bars. If it's not clear, then yes, it is length of short bar, because we are calculating bottom long bar. Length of short bar minus clear cover divided by spacing plus 1. So we'll go here, we'll do is equal to, we are taking the bottom long bar, the length of short bar minus clear cover, means 2 times 50 mm is equal to 0.1 meter. So we'll directly take it 0.1 meter, we'll bracket it down, okay? Then we'll divide it by spacing. We have provided a spacing of 100 mm. So 0.1 plus, and for an approximate result, 1. We'll enter it, it's 200. Okay, so let's see over here what it is given. 202, because we have not deducted the clear cover from here. It is 20.04 only. Okay, so let's move forward. Now, the number of bars are calculated from same formulas, right? So we can copy paste it further. Now, length of one bar. The length of one bar is calculated by the formula length of long side minus 2 times cover plus 2 times depth, development length. Okay, so is equal to, for long side, longer, minus 2 times cover, means for 0.1. okay, we'll bracket it down, minus 2 times cover, this is the length minus cover plus 2 times what, the depth minus cover. We'll close the bracket and get the answer, 44.31. yes, it's same. Now the number of bars into length. The total length is calculated as the number of bars multiplied by the length of one bar. We get the total length. Weight per meter, we all know the formula, D square L upon 162. So is equal to D square, L is 1 meter, divided by 162, 3.86. If you go here, 3.858. okay, then total weight, will be corrected by total weight. Okay, for total weight, we'll multiply total length by weight per meter. Number of raft, we have one number of raft over here in total length, total weight. Sorry. One raft. Okay, so here the total weight is total weight of one raft multiplied by number of rafts. Now we are getting 34,255 kg. Okay, now we will write over here because we have a dia of 25 mm. So we'll go is equal to total weight, enter. So 25 mm dia, 34,255 kg or ton. Now we'll go to here, we'll view, we'll freeze the panels above that. Okay, so these formulas are almost same. We'll copy it, we'll paste over here. Now why are these changes coming? Let us correct the formula for it. Number of bars, here it is D11. We for long bar we took short length, for short bar we will take long length. Okay, the length of bar, for length of one bar, long bar we have took long length, for short bar we'll take short length, and same E11 will be. Take from it for 20 numbers. Okay, for 19, and here the length is 22.44. Depth. Yes, here we come 22.44. Total length is of course number of bars into length of one bar, then weight per meter, d square l upon 162. Total weight, total length into weight per meter, number of raft is equal to 1, and total weight is this. So I will again copy this and paste over here. Now in top long bar it is taken short length, in this we have to take long one, and E11 is 1.35. just for a little change, here the capital D is 0.6 meter. Why we are taking a 0.6? Yeah, 43.08, because it is given in drawing, the red portion. Okay, so total weight again same, weight per meter same, total weight same, number of raft and 10. Now we'll again copy it, now we'll paste over here. For top short bar, long length, for length of one bar, for short length, then multiply it, weight per meter, bear total weight of one raft, number of raft one, and then we'll get the values. Sight time, this is the shape of sight time, the total length the total length minus 2 times clear cover. Okay, so for taking out the numbers, we'll go over here. It's the sight tie. We have calculated by 2 times 2. Okay, so I'm writing directly 4 over here, and on this side also 4. Length of 1 bar, that is the for long side, length of long side minus 2 times cover means 0.1. For length of short side, minus 2 times cover is 0.1. For total length, it's directly multiply this with this. Okay, weight per meter, we'll just copy paste the formula. Sorry, it is 0.40 for 8 mm, for 60 for 0.60 for 10 mm. Okay, now total weight of one raft, we'll again copy this formula and paste over here. Number of rafts is 1 for both. Total weight is, again we'll copy the formula, paste. Here we have used 8 mm, so we'll add this over here. Now we'll calculate chairs. Okay, so here we have provided two types of chairs at site, 25 dia and 16 dia. Okay, 25 dia and 16 dia. Number of bars, number of chairs, we have took on site 200 for 25 and 150 for 152.16. So this is 200 and this is 152. Length of one bar, we have took on site, we have calculated the cutting length on site. Okay, then total length, we have got all the formulas, we have to just keep in mind and take that out. Weight per meter, okay, then total length, then total weight, number of raft, and total weight. Okay, here it is 25 mm, so we'll add over here. It is 16 mm, we'll add over here. Okay, so laps, for laps what is given, 2 on each bar and 2 on each side. Okay, oh sorry, 2 on each bar. Now laps, so it is given 2 on each bars, means the bars, we have total number of bars on long side, for taking top long and bottom long, we have whatever the total number of bars, like for raft bottom long, raft top long, for this bottom long 2 times for bottom long bar, enter here 2 times top long, top long, enter. This is 2 times for bottom short, bottom short, and this is 2 times for top short, top short. Okay, now length of one bar, for that we have a formula, 50 times d divided by 1000, so is equal to 50 times dia divided by 1000. Same formula over there. Total length is this multiplied by this. We'll get the total length. Weight per meter, same over here and over all here. Okay, because the number of diameter of bars are similar, weight per meter is also similar. Total weight of one raft is total length multiplied by weight per meter and this. Number of raft, yeah, total weight then. Now for these all are 25 mm, so we'll write over here. Okay, done. Now we will calculate each and every diameter bar. We have used 8 mm, 16 mm and 25 mm. So total for 8 mm for 16 mm. And for 25 mm. This much in kg. Now we'll find out in ton. It's easy. We have to divide it by 1000. Just need to copy paste over here. So these are the values in tons. Okay. Now if you want to take out the cost of the reinforcement, you just have to multiply the cost per ton into the weight per ton. Okay. So this is the calculation of BS1. Now I had found out the calculation of BS1. The BS1 small lift weight, I will tell you in another lecture, or total lift weight. The BS2 of diagonal verticals, BS2 of straight vertical, and BS2 of straight horizontal. So now I'll tell you what is the diagonal vertical. In diagonal vertical, the length is taken by the average. Like you have we have calculated the rectangular part. I'll show it here. We have calculated the rectangular part, so we know how to calculate the rectangular part quantity. So the BS2 straight vertical is the rectangular, BS2 straight horizontal is again a rectangular, you can calculate it. But what about this? Half portion is diagonal, half portion is rectangle. So we'll cut this. Okay, now the length is taken, we'll add, suppose this length is 15 meter and the diagonal length is rest. So we'll take 15 plus, we'll take approximately 3 widths from here and we'll average it on. So after getting that length, we'll take out of BS2. This is the drawing if you want to refer it. This is the lift pit, we'll check in another class. And sorry, this one is the bar bending schedule if you want to check it out. Okay, so guys, if you like my class, please share it with your friends. Please subscribe my channel for more videos. And if you really like the video, please hit the like button. Thank you.